carbon weevils. The great spinning mother lays down her fat reserves. Her burbling tummy rumbles and burps. Her waters gurgle and surge, swishing back and forth, sloshing the rich luxuriance of her pregnant pullulation. Endlessly she re-erupts, readjusting her crusts, renewing her plate-grinding tectonic bones. As all across her gorgeous, curvaceous body, her tiny cleaners swarm. They lick, spit, suck, limp, swish, slope, swerve, and splurge, and she sustains them as they sustain her. Amidst her complex, toothsome, bulging, self-sustaining, multi-storied space, forever laying down and dying, layer upon countless layer, rotting and revolving round and round, she squeezes them harder and harder between her vast plates as she lays down her fat reserves, the larders to sustain all life to come. And in these great subterranean seas of ooze, carbon atoms wait in humming droves for their next time to come around. And so the carbon weevil is at work, not just one carbon weevil, but an entire species working tirelessly and as one, burrowing in and lancing the fat reserves, excavating, tunneling, rearranging, reordering, releasing the carbon atoms, first the forests, then the coal, now the oil, syringing it out of her vast and toothsome pie crust, evolving ever more elaborate systems, mouth parts, proboscis extensions and ovipostals. And so the carbon weevil sing, burrow down, bring it up, burn it up and bring it on. Burrow down, bring it up, burn it up and bring it on. Now let's zoom in and observe the carbon weevil's evolution. At the time of shooting the next frame, there were precisely 6,713,008,180 carbon weevils alive. If every single carbon weevil on Earth was herded together and then rolled up into a single squidgy ball, they would only be this big next to the Earth. Their collective sperm would fit into a matchbox and their eggs into an egg cup. Fade to black, fade up. Let us now observe its life cycle. The carbon weevil starts out as two distinct microbial life forms, a sperm and an egg. It rapidly evolves into an adult carbon weevil, in appearance most like a forked worm. They are capable of achieving great sizes before quite suddenly shriveling up and dying. Carbon weevils are themselves 20% carbon and have evolved to re-release this vital carbon as fast as possible back into the atmosphere rather than the slow release technique favoured by other species which can take anything up to a million years. Carbon weevils mostly live in packs, in vast spreading nest sites that cover huge areas of the earth, stacking themselves on top of one another in huge piles, row upon row, line upon line. They construct their cocoons from rocks and minerals which they nibble up from the earth's crust and glue together using what is believed to be drool from their primitive salivary glands. Weevils lay down intricate gum trails made of hot melted carbon which dries, often creating beautiful patterns when seen from above, criss-crossing, underpassing, ringing and bypassing. Down these hardened gum trails, the weevils swarm. They've evolved shells, much like crabs or snails, in which they traject themselves at fantastic speeds, often piling on top of each other in mass spewings of CO2. They are happiest of all when linked together in long bottom-sniffing chains, often moving only an inch in an entire hour. These highly developed carbon rituals are regarded by many as the pinnacle of carbon weevil social interface. Carbon weevil weevils have evolved to traject themselves in herds into the air inside tubes which travel at huge speeds across huge distances so that they can lie in rows of roasting themselves or conglomerate in huge pan-global hot air sessions before catapulting themselves home a few days later. Carbon weevils are happy bunnies who are nearly always obliterating one another in huge numbers somewhere on Earth. They love doing this for the accelerated release of CO2 that it produces. These outbursts are always set off by hot air generated in special hot air chambers somewhere on the other side of the world. Much like their close cousin the green fly, carbon weevils can drop 320 young a minute, so that their population is increasing precisely this fast. Each individual weevil is capable of consuming 400,000 tons of food in its 70-year lifespan. Vast swathes of the world are cleared and covered in fantastic self-repeating patterns, where single plant species are laid out and forced to grow at amazing speeds. Other inhabitants of the world are packed and fattened in enormous receptacles to be chopped and minced and pulped into pastes or pasties, mashes and mushes on which the weevils blissfully graze. And so, as far as we can tell, the carbon weevil serves no other evolutionary role than to release the Earth's carbon and turn it into carbon dioxide. We are only at the very beginnings of understanding this remarkable and inexhaustible little species, and many of its apparently pointless activities and rituals are still quite beyond us. Suffice it to say that such is the vast time scale of evolution that we may not know for millions of years why it was here, before it became swallowed like so many before it into those vast self-regulating memory banks of the great spinning mother.